Well, you know, God said something to me about 6 weeks ago, about 2024, very simple. He said, draw closer to him. Tell the people that. The second thing he said is bind the thief. And I tell you, there's no greater way than to do both of those, draw near to God, bind the thief, than to consecrate yourself in a fast before the Lord. You know, Luke 4, it increases the power. That's what happened to Jesus. He came out in the power of the Spirit. Daniel 10, Daniel prayed for 21 days. And as a result, his words, the first day that he spoke it, those angels came. But watch this. Those of you that are watching Flashpoint Army, why Pastor George is hearing from God. Daniel's fast caused something to happen in the atmosphere, in the spirit realm, in the natural, that concerned nations. I'm telling you, we're going to see breakthrough. Isaiah 58, Pastor George talked about rewards. The Bible talks about when you fast, you break the bands of wickedness. You set the oppressed and let them go free. You destroy yokes. You undo heavy burdens. But here's a reward. Light will spring forth. That's breakthrough. The Bible says when you call upon God in Isaiah 58, after you fast, He'll answer you. You get answered prayer. Says God will guide you. And watch this. Lastly, God will heal you in your body. But how about this? He will heal our great country, the United States. So I am a part of this. Pastor George, you're hearing from God. Watch what the Lord does to bring victory after victory to this great country and to the people for what they've been through.
Yeah, amen. All right, Andrew, I'll get you to weigh in there on doing this fast.
Well, you know, I really appreciate what Pastor George said. The things that he was emphasizing is how it changes our heart, makes us more sensitive, how we hear from God and stuff. And so many people think that fasting is somehow or another like a lever that gives you extra pull on God. And if you approach it with that attitude that this is something you're going to do to make God move, I think you totally undo the effects of a fast. You know, there's a verse right here in Matthew chapter 17 where Jesus said that, "Howbeit this kind goeth not out, but by prayer and fasting." And people often take that's talking about certain demons only leave through prayer and fasting. But the subject of the previous verse was the subject of unbelief. Why couldn't we cast the devil out? He said it's because of unbelief. And I believe fasting casts unbelief out of us because it's taking away everything that's distracting us and just putting our focus completely on God. And that's really the power of a fast. It makes us laser focused on God because we are denying our flesh.
Amen. All right. So you can find out more about this, Pastor George, at emic.org/fast. What are they going to get when they go there?
Oh, Gene, there's all kinds of things on there. There's a sheet that they can have that they can fill out on the back, the things that they're believing God for. There are messages that I've taught. There's four messages that Brother Copeland has taught on fasting and prayer, information that they need, the scriptures. It's loaded with the information. And we began the fast today. Today was the day we started. So for 21 days, we are setting our faces before God, all of us, and we are going to see breakthroughs. We're going to see things take place in our nation, in our lives, in Israel, in the elections, and I really hadn't announced this to the church yet, but I'm thinking about another one as we get into this year, because the closer we come to those elections, we need to be hearing from God. We need to hear from on high to know what to say, to know what to pray, and to know what to do.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor George, for dropping by for the Flashpoint Army. If you want more information, go to emic.org/fast. You can get more information, understand what it is. I know we kind of skimmed over the top of a lot of the details if you're not familiar with it, but there you can download absolutely free. All the materials are free and find out more about it. Any final words, Pastor George, before we let you go?
I just want you to know that this is going to change lives. And Amen. If you enter into this, you can jump in now. Even though it started today, you can jump in now with us on this, and you'll be able to see things in your lives that you've never seen before. If you've never done this before, just pick out something that you like, you enjoy. I've been talking to my church about what they're doing concerning social media. Think about it. Fasting social media. Wow. What a challenge, but what a reward that God gives us in this fast.
Amen. Thank you, sir. Thank you for coming by.
Thanks, Gene.
emic.org/fast for all of the information. All right, let's move on to the next thing. Listen, I want to say something here that I did not get to earlier. If for some reason you're not getting our program, you need to make sure you follow us on Rumble. That's rumble.com/flashpoint. You can always get our program there. We're being suppressed and the algorithms are not working for us. I get emails and texts from people on messages that about like, well, they're not letting me know when y'all are live anymore. Well, this is the way to make sure you don't miss a thing is follow us on Rumble. It's very simple. Rumble.com/flashpoint. There's the channels there. The shows are live there as well as they are hosted there. Other videos are there. I think there's well over 400 videos there right now. You want to be a part. Follow us there. All right. Well, let's go to some news of what's been happening. U.S. Senate leader Chuck Schumer just threatened to send the U.S. soldiers to fight Russia in eastern Ukraine if the border bill isn't passed. Watch this.
We're at a turning point in America. This bill is crucial, and history will look back on it and say, did America fail itself? Why is it crucial? Well, if we don't aid Ukraine, Putin will be walk all over Ukraine. We will lose the war, and we could be fighting in Eastern Europe in a NATO ally in a few years. Americans won't like that. If we don't help Israel defend itself against Hamas, that perpetual war will go on and on and on. If we don't help humanitarian aid to the starving Palestinians in Gaza, hundreds of thousands could starve. And the border, everyone has said it's chaos. A speaker, you just saw Speaker Johnson, he said it's chaos. We have to do something legislative a few months ago. But what has happened, in answer to your question, so this is crucial for America. It's a turning point. History is going to look over our shoulders and say, did we rise to the occasion? To his credit, Mitch McConnell did. But too many Republicans, including Speaker Johnson, are just scared to death of Donald Trump. Donald Trump has said he wants chaos. Donald Trump has said, well, wait till I become president. That'll take at least a year. Ukraine could be gone. The border will get much worse. War in the Middle East will get worse, maybe bringing us into it. He's doing it all for political reasons. And let me just say, will senators, the crucial question, the $64,000 question, the majority of Republican senators know this bill is the right thing to do. It's a compromise. I don't like everything in it. Neither does McConnell. But it's a compromise. That's the only way you get things important done in the Senate. We proved that 2 years ago in our bipartisan legislation. And will the senators drown out the political noise from Trump and his minions and do the right thing for America? It's a crucial question. History is looking down on every one of us right now.
All right, so history's looking down on every one of us, you know, gloom and doom here. But Pastor Hank, you know, when you hear this, what he said at the very end there is really what he wanted to say, Trump and his minions. I'll give you first shot at that. Go ahead.
Well, let's talk about Chucky and his little minions, okay? This is all about their fear of Donald Trump coming back into a place of power. And those of us who are awakened in this country that realize that what Chucky just said is ridiculous. First and foremost, what are we doing in the Ukraine? Why are we sending billions of dollars? Why are we involving ourselves? What kind of handshakes? What deals have been done underneath the table, Chucky and your minions? Because really, this is not about Ukraine. This is about the United States border that is open, that is allowing terrorists to come at an accelerated rate, and it's about America first. Think about this, Pastor Gene. They're limiting it in this bill, okay, to 5,000 a day. What are they going to do? Get a raffle and see which one their number falls on, then you can come over the border. This is ridiculous. Listen, there needs to be closed borders. You come to this country legally, bottom line. And lastly, we should not be manipulated by these Democrats or rhinos that are trying to make Ukraine part of the deal. That is ridiculous. America first. And I thank God for Donald Trump. That's his policy, that's his heart, and his focus, and that's where America needs to stand, along with Texas.
All right, man. All right, Andrew, I'll give you a chance at that. I mean, he's tying our border to this war with Ukraine and Russia. What do you think is the right answer here?
Well, first of all, the Democrats are the one that created the border crisis, and now they're trying to make it look like they're the ones who's fixing it, and if any Republicans stand against it, they're the ones that have caused the problem. And that is just absolutely a lie. I've heard that there's over 6 million illegal aliens, and I forget the numbers, but it's hundreds of thousands every single month that are coming in, and that is totally created by Biden not enforcing the law. He doesn't have to do immigration reform. If he would just enforce the laws that are on the books, if he would put it back into effect, the things that he canceled from Trump when the illegal immigration was way low, if he hadn't have changed things, we wouldn't be in this problem. So for them to come up and now act like we've got the solution, the only reason they're doing this is because elections are coming up and immigration is a losing issue. And so they're trying to make it look like they are doing something about it. And yet they're the ones that created this border crisis. And it's all smoke and mirror, accusing your adversaries of the very things that you're guilty of is what they're doing.
Yeah, smoke and mirror is exactly right. Let me show you this. In fact, I'm going to bring in Kylie Jean Tannehill is here early, so I'm going to bring her in to comment on this. This is Representative Ana Paulina Luna. In honor of Chuck Schumer, I'll be introducing a bill that requires any politician who advocates for sending American troops to Ukraine to be required to fight on the front lines right there with them. What do you think, Kylie
Jean?
That's
not a bad idea.
I think that's a pretty good counteroffer that she has there. I agree with Andrew and Hank that this is exactly smoke and mirrors, and it's just a beautiful verbal distraction and propaganda move to get Americans distracted and completely uneducated when it comes to our border issue. We are funneling in terrorists and immigrants that are creating a war from within. So they want us to get distracted on what's happening on the outside because we will crumble from within if it's not taken care of.
Let me show you what Senator Mike Lee from Ukraine, he had to say about all of this. I don't have it, guys, here in my but I know that there's a tweet there. Can you show that? Fun fact, U.S. Marine, look, basically, let me sum it up. The whole budget for 23 was $53 billion. They're wanting to send 60 to Ukraine. This is crazy, Kylie Jean. This is crazy what they're trying to do.
Yeah, we've already sent over millions and billions with a B. It's interesting because war always seems to be really profitable, and especially when it comes into election season. And so my encouragement right now to every single American, especially born-again believers, is this is why discernment is so key and why it's so important that we're educated on the issues of the time, what is happening, and to be able to address the underlying reality so that we can peer through the deception that's at play.
Let me show you this. Here's Alex Mersowitz shows this full list of Senate Republicans trying to kill uniparty border bill. Marsha Blackburn, Ted Cruz, Steve Daines, Josh Hawley, Ron Johnson, Mike Lee, Rand Paul, Marco Rubio, Rick Scott, Eric Schmidt, J.D. Vance, Tommy Tuberville. The reason I read those, because that's who you need to be looking at. These are people you need to take note of who's standing up and who's cowering, and these guys are standing up. They're coming against this. Listen, we all know that D.C. is a bunch of, it's the swamp and there's politics, but what we have to have is we must have men and women that will stand up for what's right for America, the whole, not just for what meets their own personal private entities and their pork projects and what they want. Pastor Hank, this is a big deal. In fact, if I remember right, there was a prophetic word about this that came out about those people will be revealed.
Yes. Well, I think we're in a very interesting time right now, Pastor Gene. And first and foremost, thank God that we're seeing people in our great country that we've elected start standing up. There should be no deal whatsoever. Bottom line is we stand with Texas and what they're doing to stand at a time when our country desperately needs order in the border. That's why border has the word order. But God did say we're going to see some things begin to be exposed. We're going to see that there's been a lot of handshakes underneath the table, including the Ukraine, because we're in a governmental year, 2024. There were 24 elders that sit with the risen, ascended Christ in the court of heaven, and the court of heaven is ruling now with its verdict. And in no way will God clear the guilty, and we are going to see righteousness righteousness and justice. And I'm going to tell you, Pastor Gene, I think we're going to see God do something with that bill that's going to bust it up. And I think we're going to continue to see that Texas may be a lone star, but other great states or stars in this great country are going to begin to stand with Texas. And there's going to be something that's going to shift this country, that we're going to see a unity out of the division, because God's going to use it to deliver this nation. He did it with the Red Sea. It parted on the right and the left, and God drowned the agenda of the Egyptians and delivered a nation in a day. And I believe this is where we're heading in this great country.
Well, let me show you this short video. And Andrew, I'm going to come to you out of this. Speaker Mike Johnson on Meet the Press talking about Joe Biden and the border. Watch.
The president of the United States opened the border. We documented 64 specific actions that Joe Biden and his agencies have taken to create this catastrophe. They did it intentionally. That's why his approval rating is in the tank. 60% of the people disapproved by your latest poll. The reason the presidency is imperiled, as your opening monologue stated, is because this is an abject failure of leadership. The American people are done with this. The border has to be secured. And the president has the authority right now. He doesn't need an another act of Congress. He could do it right now, but he's unwilling to do it.
He's unwilling to do it. There, Andrew, I mean, he brings up a point that the mainstream media is not bringing up, the fact that he has the power right now to do something about it. I'll let you comment.
Well, again, I think we need to notice that this is an election year. They've had 3 years to do something, and all they've done is make things worse. Kamala Harris is supposed to be in charge of the border, and man, if she is, what an abject failure. And so instead of looking at their ploys where they're trying to present themselves as if they are the ones who's going to solve this border crisis, we need to look at it that it's election. This is nothing but smoke and mirrors. And they are just, again, trying to position themselves. And people need to be smart enough not to judge them on what they are quote-unquote saying, but look at what they've done. If we judge the Biden administration and the Democrats on what they've done, it is disgraceful, and I guarantee you, we ought to vote them all out.
I so agree.
That's my opinion.
I agree. I'm with you on that one. All right, so if you're watching anything on social media or alternative media, you're seeing about what's going on at the border. Now, we know that Texas is doing, Governor Abbott is doing a little bit there at Eagle Pass, but a half mile down the road, it's a wide open door. Don't think Texas got the whole border shut off. That's not the case. We still have a lot of room to grow, a lot of stuff that needs to happen here. But what they're trying to do is, and Andrew kind of it keeps pointing back to this, is the fact that we're dealing with an election year. Everything is about perception. How do you perceive this? How does the public perceive, oh, Joe Biden's going to do something about the border? How does the public perceive that? Because they're trying to get you to vote. Oh, look, see, it's not really that bad. We're trying to close the border. That's why you must pay attention to what you're seeing. All right? Here's 60 Minutes clip on navigating the border that I bet you didn't know. Watch.
We wondered how all of these migrants knew about this particular entryway into California. The answer was in their hands.
TikTok.
Oh, you learned on TikTok. Yeah. TikTok is a social media platform created in China. The post we found had step-by-step instructions for hiring smugglers and detailed directions to that hole we visited. We were struck by just how orderly and routine it all seemed. The migrants walked about a half mile down a dirt road and waited in line for U.S. Border Patrol to arrive so they could surrender.
Okay, Kylie Jean, they're getting information on TikTok. Are you kidding me?
That seems pretty strategic to me there, Gene. TikTok, in the algorithm that we see here in the United States, it's no secret that they're pumping out content that is brainwashing our youth, and it's educating our children to get more gains off of trendy dances, and we are giving a play-by-play action step for illegals to cross our borders and come into our nation. If you ask me, it is so clear that this is an agenda with an attack on identity in every realm in our nation. A nation does not have a clear identity if it does not have secure borders. We see the attack on our youth, with a clear agenda that's coming through social media, that's happening in the classroom, that's happening to disband the nucleus family. So it's very clear that there's something strategic and bigger than just what we see happening on the news.
Let me show you what's going on here this week as well for Colorado. Laura Loomer posts this, the Supreme Court hearing this Thursday. That's the night we start. Regarding President Trump's ballot access case is one of the most consequential and important days in the history of our nation. It'll decide whether or not Trump can be on the ballot in 2024. Then she goes on to say, not a single Republican lawmaker has anything planned to support Trump this Thursday in D.C. Okay, so Kylie Jean, you hear this. This is so crucial because if this were to be instated where he's banned from, then that's going to cause other states just to jump on board because there's precedent been set. What do you think?
I think this is consistent with the intimidation tactics that multiple states have shown throughout Trump's presidency, throughout this process coming into this election. And I just want to state right now, it will not stand. The spirit of the living God is so much stronger than the operations and the mode of the enemy. And I'm confident, and why even this week is so important that Flashpoint is going to Colorado, is to gather the people and to make a stand, not only in the natural, but in the spirit. So yes, does this look like it can be horrifically bad news and other states would jump on board? Absolutely. But it's a but God moment.
Yeah, it is. It is a God moment. Pastor Hank, your thoughts?
Well, I agree with Kylie Jean. The Spirit of God is upon this country. The Spirit of God is upon President Trump. And the Spirit of God is listening to the remnant who are praying, and God's righteousness and justice are in manifestation. Pastor Gene, many times I've had my little feather here about all these indictments and stuff that they're trying to do to Donald Trump. And from the start, the Spirit of God said, like a feather, they'll fall. This is what's going to happen with their attempt to continue to exclude President Trump, try to frame him, and all the other ridiculous things. Because we go back to 2021, when God spoke and said, there are two that he has placed his hand upon, and he spoke in this order. He said, first, I speak of Netanyahu. Second, I speak of Donald Trump. I put my anointing upon them, and they shall be raised up in the earth. And people wrote our ministry because they said, well, how can it be with Netanyahu and all the things that they were trying to do in Israel? Look at what happened. God fulfilled what he said regarding Netanyahu, and he will fill it regarding Donald Trump. But we've got to continue to decree and stand strong in faith and don't back off for a moment, because God's got an agenda, and that is to make this country, America, great again.
Andrew, you know, we would stand on this for any candidate, any president that was being called in to be off the ballot. I mean, this case really has nothing to do with Republican or Democrat, yet it seems to have been marginalized to be a Republican issue. What's your thoughts?
Well, again, it's much more than just right or left, Republican or Democrat. It's evil. Is what it's did. They're trying to undo our freedoms and liberties. And again, speaking from a Coloradan perspective, I moved here in 1978, and Colorado was actually a conservative state. And the man who is now our governor, Jared Polis, he's an open homosexual. He's the very first governor elected in the United States that was a homosexual. And he and three other people who are millionaires and billionaires, who one of them is a transgender and things, about 15 years ago, they came together with a plan and lots of money to take over this state. And they did. And it is not the opinion of the average person in Colorado. We have been hijacked. And we've been fighting against it. We've taken over 600 people to the Capitol and kept them there all night long listening to our testimony. And yet we've got transgender people in our Congress. We've got a governor who's open homosexual. They are deliberately hijacking this state. And Gene, I just appreciate you making Colorado your first stop on this tour, because we need the visible representation, and we need all of these people to come, and I believe it's going to make a difference.
It is going to make a difference in Jesus' name.